The Olympics are coming to China in 2022. Should the Western world be involved with it? I don't know, but David Mulroney has some views on that. He was Canadian ambassador to China for 3 years. He joins me right now. And there is starting to be some controversy. And I understand the government is saying, well, you Olympians, you figure it out. But it has national implications. China is a regressive government. Should Canadians participate?
So first of all, the federal government gets the gold medal for a buck passing in not making that decision. You know, let's think back to 2008, the Beijing Summer Games.
Right.
What happened that earlier in that year? Major riots in Tibet and a brutal Chinese crackdown. And people at that time thought, how can we have the Olympics? And then we heard what we're hearing now. Oh, it's an opportunity for athletes to be ambassadors of goodwill and peace. What it was a chance for the world to come to China and pay tribute, as only the Chinese can exact tribute. They effectively laundered their terrible behavior in Tibet and emerged more arrogant and more repressive than ever. Do we have to do this again in 2022?
We aren't going to be changing China. I mean, Bill Clinton learned that from when he was president and what he did with globalization. Let's look back for a second to 1936, when the world attended the Olympics in Germany. Hitler was in full force, although the world didn't view him then as evil as it does now. But the evil was still going on there. China is rubbing out the Muslim community. They're fighting with India. Do you think then that if we go to the Olympics, we are condoning that?
Yes, and there are two big problems. One is, I believe what's happening in Western China, in Xinjiang, constitutes genocide. If you look at the Genocide Convention, what China is doing is basically dismantling and erasing an entire society. So that, how can we go and compete when that's happening as we're there? The second thing is, something I alluded to earlier, China uses these events to bring the world to Beijing, as the emperors did, to pay tribute, to exact from us our endorsement of what they're doing.
If we don't go, should we be afraid of the repercussions?
Well, you know, when we boycotted the Moscow Games, the concern was the damage it would do to the Olympics. The concern now is the punishment that China will levy. Why are we getting into this? We need to think about how China's using international organizations and events to co-opt us.
Just as the world in the late 1930s were wondering about Hitler. Do we want to fight this evil man and what he's doing there? And the world learned that, yes, you have to. So is war inevitable?
War is not inevitable. And Xi Jinping, who's the leader of China, is a bit of an outlier. He has, it's not a political system like ours, but he has people around him that he has to work with. And they're quietly watching as the world begins to express greater and greater concern about China. So Xi is vulnerable. And something like an Olympic boycott would be a disaster for China, a disaster for the Games, but a real disaster for Xi Jinping.
And while he's a dictator, he has to pay attention to who supports him.
Absolutely.
David Mulroney, thanks very much.
Thank you.
A bit longer than 3 minutes, but it was worth it. So thank you for watching, and please make sure that you subscribe and tell your friends. We are going to have lots of fabulous shows coming up in the new year.